So we've determined that we want to figure out which set of parameters provide the best predictions for our output variable, but how can we do that? We'll use an algorithm called gradient descent. First, we need to define some cost function, which we'll call j of big theta. I'm going to use big theta here to represent our entire set of thetas, and I'll use this notation throughout the rest of this lesson. The cost function is meant to provide a measure of how well our current set of thetas does at modeling the observed data. So we want to minimize the cost function's value. As we discussed just a moment ago, when we're doing linear regression, our cost function, j of theta, can simply measure the sum of the squares of the differences between our predicted and observed values. I'm going to formalize this a little bit and say this. J of big theta is equal to 1/2 times the sum from I equals 1 to m of y predicted of xi minus y observed I squared, where y predicted xi equals the sum of n from 0 to big N of theta n xni. So there's a lot going on here, and I've color-coded this, so why don't we walk through it? First, we're just saying that j of big theta is equal to 1/2 times the sum over all of our data points of the predicted y, given our x's, our input variables, minus the observed y squared. So this is just our error squared term, summed over all the data points. No different than the equation that we have up here. Down here, we're just defining the way that we calculate the predicted value of y, given our input variables. And the way that we do that is that we say we sum from n equals 0 to big N of theta n times xn. So we're just saying that we sum up the xn, each input variable, times its weight, theta. This is no different than the sum that we had on the last slide. Note that we include an n equals 0 term here, which corresponds to a constant term in our model, which doesn't correspond to any of the input variables. For those of you familiar with linear algebra, if we wanted to, we could also express this as theta transpose times x. If you don't know linear algebra, don't worry about this. This is just another way of expressing the same thing here that might be easier for some students to comprehend.